Hello and welcome back to HiFi Lo-Fi. Today I'm going to show you my old cassette deck. It's not one I've had from new. It's a 1974 model Victor, if I zoom in a bit, KD-31 stereo cassette deck. Okay, there we are. So I bought this from a professional restorer. He just seems to restore old audio equipment and sell it on Yahoo Auction Japan, and I couldn't resist it because I do have a fondness for these old brushed aluminium audio machines with analog VU meters especially, and this particular model is before they started using soft touch and solenoids and all the rest of it. So it's got these very sturdy transport controls here, very solid sturdy transport controls, and let's have a look. So we've got left and right mic socket inputs, and we've got headphones there. That's the old traditional size, and the input selector there, you can select between line, which is for the just the standard RCA analog connectors at the back, input output for RCA left and right channels, input and output for playback and record. It's also got a DIN socket on the back. Sorry, I'm not going to take it out and show you because it's a lot of hassle moving this stuff around. But DIN, by the way, used to be a very popular multi-pin connection system, and it's got an old circular type. It was I'll see if I can find a link and post it in the description. But it was originally developed in Germany, I believe, about 50 years ago. And yes, we've got ANRS, which is a noise reduction system comparable to Dolby B. Now, back in the day, Dolby B was all the rage, but some manufacturers developed their own systems. ANRS is one such alternative system that some people say you could play back a Dolby B recorded cassette tape and utilize ANRS to the same end to get the same results, and vice versa. You could use ANRS on here to record a cassette tape and play it back using Dolby B in such a machine. I don't know that yet, and I'm going to actually test that in another video and let you know what goes on when I try it. Personally, in more recent years, since I've been getting back into cassette decks, I do feel that Dolby is not only overrated, but I think it does definitely do something negative to the sound, has a negative impact on the sound. I don't really like Dolby anymore. But anyway, so we've got the tape type selector buttons. So these buttons are all spring loaded, by the way. And we've got selections for three types. Metal, I don't even know if metal tape was invented back in 1974 when this machine was made. If it was, it obviously wasn't popular. So we've got normal, the equalization and bias buttons are both out for normal. We've got normal, by the way, is type 1. We've got type 2, chrome, and chrome is both buttons in, and we've got ferrochrome, which is type 3. Now, type 3 cassette tapes are like gold dust. If you've got any type 3 cassette tapes, then you're very lucky. Hang on to those. I've never seen in my life, never ever in my life seen a Type 3. They had a very short run. They were not very popular for some reason. But anyway, we've got the record level, left and right channels there, and then we've got the transport controls here, and the power on. And I love the warm glow of the old analog VU meters. I love the backlights on those, absolutely fantastic. Something a bit strange, and I'm going to show you in a minute, is that it's also got these bright red LED lights that act as a VU meter, but they act as a mono VU meter because there's only one line of those. There isn't left and right, there aren't left and right channels for those. Very odd, and you'll see in a moment when they're going that, frankly, I feel that it's something I could do without, something unnecessary, and I wish they hadn't put them on, but they seem to have gone out for all the bells and whistles on this one back in the day. Right, so let's play a cassette tape now. I was rummaging through my old cassette tapes and I found this one. It's a TDK FE Ferric 90 Type 1 normal position. I don't remember recording this, but side A sounds like the kind of music I would record for myself. Probably went round to a friend's house and copied some selection from his CDs or something, or maybe even another cassette tape. But side, the second side, side two or the B side, is not the kind of thing I would have recorded for myself. So, but I'm just going to play side A. And the reason I say that is because both sides sounded absolutely great when I played them on my A&D machine here, which you can see an unboxing video of. And I'm going to do a video of this in action very soon. And quite frankly, I was blown away by the sound quality of this humble cassette from about 40, I don't know when I recorded it. It's got to be early 90s when I recorded this, possibly even 1990, but certainly early 90s. So the sound quality was fantastic in this. Let's listen to how it sounds. Now you're not going to be able to hear, look at that very soft, slow eject there. Reminds me of back in the day, my wasted youth going around shopping centres, annoying the staff in HiFi stores with my friends, where we'd go and test the eject mechanism on all the audio equipment and rate it according to how smoothly and softly the eject mechanism worked on the cassette deck. And that was our way in those days of deciding whether something was of quality or not. Yeah, I didn't mention the tape counter. So the tape counter is the old school three numeric type, very traditional, very typical back in the day. I don't know whether at that point there was any cassette deck that had started matching the tape counter to the actual time passed, but back in the day this was standard on just about every cassette deck. Right, so I've got it wired up to my Yamaha amp, and I've got it set now to pure direct. That is to say, no tone or anything else. So you can see it's got bass, treble, and it's got a loudness function on here, which is this amp. I'm not going to go into this amp now, I'll talk about it another time, but the amp has a loudness dial, so you can adjust the loudness, which is an absolutely fantastic feature. And anyway, let's hit the play button. Right, so obviously this is an 80s song, but I didn't record this tape in the 80s. My initial impression is that it's lacking bass. It's more biased towards the higher frequencies. Now that could suggest that it was recorded with Dolby. However, I absolutely don't remember what machine it was recorded on. So I can't say. And generally speaking, if you do record with Dolby and don't play back with Dolby, you do get quite a lot of hiss, and I don't hear a lot of tape hiss. Of course, everything is really reliant on various links in the chain, so you know, the source recording, that is the mastery, the original medium, such as, you know, was it recorded from a poor quality pre-recorded cassette, was it recorded from a high quality CD, you know, all these different things, what machine was it recorded on. There are so many aspects to this, but let me just turn it up a bit. Yeah, I mean, if I want to, of course, I can adjust the tone controls, and I'm not scared to adjust the tone controls. I'm not too much of a purist. I will adjust the tone controls to get the sound that I want. But yeah, sounds fine. Bearing in mind, you know, it's a 1974 machine, and it's impressive. So I will do another video where I compare the 1974 machine with the 80s machine and the 90s machine. I'm going to do another video on that. Right, let's stop that. And let's play a Type 2 cassette tape. So this Type 2 cassette tape is a newish one. I bought it a few months ago. It's not an old cassette. It's not new old stock. It is a more recent cassette tape. It's also TDK, and it's Type 2. Now, just because it's Type 2 doesn't necessarily mean that the metal is, material is chrome. But generally speaking, Type 2 does mean chrome. So I'm going to have to press these two buttons in. I recorded this from my computer, and these files, these tracks, are high resolution audio tracks downloaded from the internet and then run through a Dragonfly Red DAC through the USB on the back of my Windows computer, and then plugged into the cassette deck. Or was it plugged into the amp and then into the cassette deck? Can't remember. But anyway, these are high resolution audio files now recorded onto an Onkyo 1990s Onkyo cassette deck, now played back on a 1974 cassette deck. Let's listen. Well, the first thing I notice is the frequencies are biased towards the lower range of frequency. So it's more bassy and more mid-range, but it would need to have a better listening experience. I would need to adjust the tone controls to a bit more treble. Just another point, remember I said about this annoying red LED VU meter above the analog. Don't know why they would put two types on there. Personally, don't like that red one, but I'll put up with it. Yeah, I mean, obviously I should sit further back. I'm sitting right between the speakers, and I'm using Dali Oberon 5 speakers, which are fantastic value for money, by the way. Talk about those another time too. But you know, bearing in mind it's a 1974 cassette deck, I do hear very, very slight wow and flutter, by the way. Now, the guy said he restored it. And by the way, it's got full auto stop. And what that means is, it means that full auto stop means not only on play, but it will automatically stop on rewind and forward wind. That's what that means. Well, there we are. So today was just a quick look at my cassette deck, and yeah, very happy with it. It's a big boy toy, and I think it's less about the listening experience with this and much more about the aesthetics and the nostalgia and just simply owning a piece of vintage hi-fi and the whole retro experience, you know, the whole history and the heritage and everything. So this is not really, I mean, back in the day this may have been audio file quality. It isn't audio file quality when you compare it with something like this or this, and certainly there are plenty of other cassette decks that outperform it, but I suppose for a 1974 cassette deck, and when it was new, I'm absolutely certain it sounded better when it was new. You know, it's still, for the age of this machine, not just because of when it was made, but because of how long ago it was made and how, you know, how many years it's been used and, who knows, abused, hopefully not. I think that it's a very impressive machine when you consider everything. Okay, this has been Hi-Fi Lo-Fi. Thanks for watching. Take care.